Welcome to The Snapshot, a series examining the forces shaping and driving global commodities markets today. On New Year's Eve, just hours before midnight, the TOT set sail from Corpus Christi, Texas. This seemingly unremarkable tanker was remarkable in two ways. For one, it was the first crude shipment out of the U.S. since President Obama signed a major export policy change into law. Secondly, this shipment defied almost all analysts' expectations and seemed to make little economic sense, if you're simply looking at what's become a very narrow WTI Brent spread. Now, let's take that first point. On December 18th, President Obama signed into law a 2016 government spending bill that included a provision to lift all restrictions on U.S. crude exports. But related to the second point, the change came at a time when the economics of U.S. crude exports are not exactly ideal for U.S. players, at least according to some analysts. I say not exactly because while the WTI Brent spread has tightened, Platts data shows that Eagle Ford crude, after factoring in freight rates based on Platts shipping assessments, has largely held at a discount to multiple crudes in multiple export markets, including Asia and Europe. For example, Eagle Ford delivered into the Mediterranean, home of the French port of Lavera, averaged at a $6 a barrel discount to the comparatively local suite of Zeri light crude over the past 30 days. It is possible the buyer of the crude, Vitol, is taking the Eagle Ford cargo to its Cressier refinery in Switzerland, which is connected to Lavera via a pipeline. Now, was this first cargo an aberration? Was it an attempt by Vitol or Newstar or ConocoPhillips to be the first U.S. player on the world market? Well, it's clear this cargo won't be the last. Vitol is also the buyer of a separate 600,000 barrel cargo of Eagle Ford crude scheduled to load in Houston this week. So what can we expect going forward? Well, that all depends on the price. U.S. producers didn't spend years and millions of dollars lobbying for export policy changes because they think they're going to ship out a marginal amount of crude every year. At the same time, U.S. crude will only be exported when the price is right. And that is why it is useful to look beyond the WTI Brent spread into prices for other crudes sold on the world market. The WTI Brent spread is, and will remain, an important indicator for crude flows into and out of the U.S. But it is certainly not the be-all and end-all for arbitrage economics. Until next time on The Snapshot, we'll be keeping an eye on the markets.